Hey everybody, welcome back to SWX Tonight. In tonight's Coach's Corner, I'm joined by the legend, Fairfield head coach Les Meyer. Coach, how are you doing today?
Yeah, doing good, thank you.
Thank you for coming in. So you guys kind of got a little bit of a later start to the season. You guys started a week later. Do you think that gave you guys a benefit at all?
I actually don't. It might have helped us a little bit in terms of getting guys with enough practices. But once the season starts, I think that's just the way it is. You get some things on film and then you start working from there.
When we talked last time in that preseason, one of the main things we spoke about was Fairfield's team being a lot younger than it has been maybe in years past. What are some difficulties that you've dealt with so far this season with that?
We're not necessarily a young team. What we are is kind of an inexperienced team. Yeah, most of the time that we've dealt with this year has been some injuries. Right now, we're just plugging in the pieces.
Keeley has been the new face and kind of the talk of the town, so to say, since he's kind of stepped up in that position. What have you seen from him that you've been happy with so far?
Yeah, we knew what we were going to get in Keeley. He's a very good athlete, and he's cerebral in his approach to athletics. The main thing is getting the pieces around him, getting them those guys some more experience, finding not necessarily the best 11 players, but getting the players that are going to make up the best team.
You've got two wins under your belt so far this year. Kind of talk about some positives that you've taken away from those games.
The one thing that we were happy with in that first game was execution that we were able to play with a new team. But a lot of those kids have been running those plays for a while now, so it was nice to have that kind of execution, and I thought we played real hard. I thought in the game two, it was nice to maybe not play our best, but some of that is attributed to our opponent who played very well. And then to be able to come out at halftime with some adjustments and see how they responded, which I think we were very happy with.
One of the Eagles' strong suits has been defense, at least the last couple of years that I've paid attention to, and that trait's kind of carried over this year. You guys have given up, 14 points this year?
Yeah.
How have you been able to kind of perfect this defense with, like you said, an inexperienced team?
Coach Brown and Coach Rogers are in charge of the defensive line and linebackers, and our linebackers are going to be fairly experienced by the end of the season, and then maybe that'll give us some time for the offense to catch up a little bit.
You guys are back home tomorrow. You've got a Conrad team who's still trying to figure out their identity this year. What do you think that matchup's going to look like?
It'll be interesting because this week's homecoming week, which the kids always enjoy homecoming. I don't know if coaches do necessarily. Yes, they may be finding themselves, but they're well coached and they are playing hard. So the main thing is we're just going to have to be able to line up and execute and worry about ourselves and try not to worry about the other team.
That halfway point's kind of approaching quickly. What are some things you're hoping to kind of get perfected this week as you go into that second stretch of the season?
We had a few penalties last game, and I think we're going to have some again this game. But that's one area of concern for us. Main thing is we haven't been able to play with continuity on the offensive line in terms of faces yet. And so we're going to have to hit that stretch here in the next couple weeks where we can solidify that just a little bit.
Awesome. Well, good luck tomorrow. We'll, of course, be there. We'll have the highlights coming up on our 10:30 show on Friday, so be sure to join us there. But for now, we'll be right back after this.